Hi, it's Dr. Weideman again, and I'm going to show you how to use StatCrunch for linear regression problems that are covered in Chapter 7 and 8 in our book. I'm going to actually work with a problem from Chapter 8 because it's a pretty interesting data set. But it talks about, and here I am in the ebook on page 238, it's talking about the age of marriage for men and women, the age of their first marriage, and it used data from the Census Bureau. And if we look over time, from 1900 until the year 2000, we see that the difference in age, number one, is decreasing, but also on average the age at first marriage for both males and females is increasing. And so to work this problem, rather than looking at the individual ages, I thought it would be interesting for us to look at a graph, which is shown here, and I'm going to pull the data set up in a minute, where we calculate the difference in the average age at first marriage. And then we notice now we've got a nice linear relationship. So I'm going to go ahead and go into StatCrunch. And again, if you want to work on this data set, it's in Chapter 8 data sets, or you can find it from that page in the ebook. I think there's a link to it. Yes, there is. If you scroll up here, there's a link right here to go over to, actually not to StatCrunch, it just tells you that there is a data set, and here is that data set here. So first thing I'm going to do, like we just looked at, let's make a graph. We learned in the last chapter, in Chapter 6, to do a scatter plot, and we're going to use year as the x variable, and then that difference has already been calculated for us, the difference between the male and the men's and the women's age at first marriage. And then there's that scatter plot that you saw in the book. And if we look at the form on this one, what do we see? We see it's linear. We see the direction is negative. So the difference between men and women's age is decreasing as the years go by. And it's fairly strong. So let's go ahead and calculate the correlation. So summary stats, correlation. And again, we're going to pick year and then the difference in the ages and take a look at that. And the correlation is really strong, negative 0.87. Okay, so let's say we wanted to do a regression equation. So I'm going to go ahead and close these down here. And so to do a regression equation, very easy in StatCrunch, go to Stat, Regression, Simple Linear. Now you're going to pick your X and your Y just like you did for the scatter plot. So for X, I'm going to pick year. And for Y, I'm going to pick that difference in ages. There's a couple of things that I want to check down here because I'm going to use some additional parts of this. I want to get a fitted line plot. I want to get a histogram of the residuals. A couple more things. Residuals versus the x values. You can also use this one for your, remember we check a residual plot to see if we met that equal variance assumption. And then the other thing I'm going to do is save the residuals. And then I'm going to do compute. Now I've got a lot of windows this time. The first window is going to give me the linear regression results. And so it tells me that here's the linear regression equation right here. The difference in men and women's age at first marriage, here's the intercept, 33.4 about basically, minus, so basically it started at this, minus 0.016 per year for every year beyond, it started I think in 1900. Okay, here's our R-squared, here's our correlation coefficient that we saw before, here's our R-squared, so we can say 75% of the variation, almost 76% of the variation in the difference in men and women's age at marriage is explained by the year. Okay, now we've got other things coming up here. So all we really use in this window is the regression equation and R squared. The information down here we're not going to be using for the time being. Now let's go to the next chart. Okay, so there's our fitted line right on top of the regression. You can see nicely what's going on there. Now let's go to the next output. Here's the histogram of all the residuals. So it'd be really interesting to figure out who these residuals belong to. And actually, let me show you something if I can get this graph out of the way here, which it doesn't seem like I can. But the residuals were actually added to the data set. Let's take a look here, and let's look at which ones these relate to. So I'm going to click on this bar. Remember when I do that, it'll show me the observations in the data set. It's also going to highlight them on this graph here. So interesting to notice that the cases with the smallest residuals, the largest negative residuals, which means what in terms of the fitted regression line, are the actual points above or below the fitted line. They're actually below. They're occurring in, let me go back this way, they're occurring in the later years here, in the later, like second half. Let's go back for a second and look at Let's click up here to get rid of that pink. Let's look at this group here. So let's go back. And again, those are kind of scattered along here. So in other words, here, remember the regression line is under predicting. So it's kind of nice for you to see the relationship between different parts of the histogram, the residual of the histogram, histogram of residuals, and where they fall relative to that fitted line. So this might help you to remember that. Okay, the negative residuals, there's where the line is over predicting. And then if I go back and I select the positive residuals, the largest ones, and go back and see again, those are going to be above the line. Here the line is under predicting. And then again, here's that residual versus year. Remember, we want to look at some kind of a residual plot, and we don't want to see any kind of pattern in here, and it looks pretty good for us. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and shut this down and just show you the actual residuals are shown here. So again, if you wanted to see, let's go back and pull up that regression again. Create the regression output again. I should have saved it. So we're going to do year, and we're going to do the difference in the ages, and then I'm going to select the fitted, the histogram. Let's do the Y's versus that this time. And we already saved the residual, so we don't need to do that again. Okay, so now if I go over to my residual plot, and let's say I wanted to know more about these particular ones, I can go over here and scroll down on my data set and see actually what their values were, what their actual residuals were, things like that. So that's really helpful information to have. So I hope this will help you as you're working with regression in chapter 7 and 8.